Hey, that's for everyone watching though. This is your lab in here?
This is one of the lab rooms we have. Different scientists will, depending on the tasks they're doing, they may be working at a common use area where there's particular specialized equipment, like gel electrophoresis apparatus. You may work at your own bench, where you're processing your own samples. Most of the work that happens in our lab is studying the complex communities associated with the human body, either the gut, or the mouth, or the nose.
What are these big things right here?
These are just standard scientific equipment. Graduated cylinders for measuring liquids. Usually we make up buffers, the liquid solution around our gel electrophoresis, which is a simple technique for measuring the size of DNA fragments.
Wow.
Most of the work that we do in the lab in one way or another involves fragments of DNA and gene sequence information.
That's amazing. Thank you.
The molecular level, this agarose is a big whole mesh of openings with the chains of the gel in between it. Well, if it's a small DNA molecule, it can squeeze through these little holes pretty quickly. It's a big molecule, it keeps kind of getting hung up. And so this is a way to separate. The small molecules will move quickly and move further down the gel. The big molecules will move slowly and not move so far.
Wow.
So after a while, you can see patterns to say, oh, I've got a band right here. This is where there's a particular chunk of large DNA. Here's a chunk of small DNA down here. And it's a complicated way to make something that's invisible visible to us, which is to say we have this whole mix of different DNA molecules, but we know that the one we want is a particular size. Well, this lets us filter it. And let the small ones, well, those are moving too fast, we don't want those.
Get rid of those guys.
Here's big ones, well, let's leave those behind. But here's exactly the band we want. So it's a way that we can either just see what's present, or if we don't want to just know what's there, but we actually want to recover it, we can even literally slice it out of the gel and purify it. And now instead of a mix of a whole bunch of different DNAs, we've got just a DNA fragment we want.
Did you use this for the gut bacteria?
I wound up using this as part of that study.
How did you use it for part of that?
So the steps that I went through started from stool samples from people that had agreed to take the antibiotic. I extracted DNA from whatever was present in the poop sample, basically.
Okay.
And mostly that's bacterial DNA. There will be some human cells in there as well, but bacteria are abundant in healthy stool, and so I used chemical technique and heat. I had things almost boiling hot. And basically the cell walls, the cell membrane just kind of bust open. So now everything that was inside the cell is now leaking out all over the place.
Okay.
And then I used chemical methods to separate deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA.
You guys got that?
The stuff that our genes are made of.
Gotcha.
I used these chemical methods to just pull the DNA out and hold onto it and just kind of wash all the rest of the stuff away. So now instead of having a whole bunch of different bacterial cells mixed in here in the stool sample, now I've got the DNA from a whole bunch of different bacteria mixed up in a test tube. Well, somewhere along that DNA, in every one of the chromosomes for a bacteria, they've got one or a couple of genes that encode a very specific protein. It's actually not a protein, it's the component of a ribosome, which is the essential part of a cell. All cells have it. So there's a gene for a part of this called the 16S ribosomal RNA gene. And that is the identity card we use. It just turns out, because all bacteria have this, the sequence is similar enough that we can always recognize it and find it.
Okay.
But it's different enough that it'll be different for one bacterium than another.
Gotcha.
So it works great as just like a standard government ID card. Everyone's got their driver's license or their ID card. They should. Theoretically, if they're old enough.
Don't leave home without it if you're driving.
So instead of one person having, his utility bill and a second person having a birth certificate from a different country and a third person having a driver's license, we ask for a standard ID. Everyone's, ask for the driver's license. We're asking for the sequence of a particular gene, 16S gene. So that's our standard ID. And the different gene sequence on that standard gene tells us, oh, this is an Escherichia coli bacterium. Oh, this is a Lactobacillus bacterium. Oh, this is a different bacterium. This must have come from a, you know, Faecalibacterium prosnitzii. And so that's what we want, is to check these ID cards.